everybody, Neil here from the Four Corners, and welcome to a Ninjago 2021 Thoughts and Opinions video. Now, before we get into the main video, I would like to wish everybody a happy International Ninja Day. December 5th marks the International Ninja Day, and since I record videos prior to one day, I couldn't really wish you guys on the same date, but it's still cool, and I'm really glad my buddy told me this thing actually existed. I wonder if this International Ninja Day has this kind of party culture where people get together at each other's houses and start partying, or if it's just something that they want to recognize ninjas as. Not really sure. Hopefully it's a party culture, because that would be awesome. Since we finished that mention about that awesome day, we can get to the main topic, which is talking about how the 10th anniversary and the epic battle sets are going to have a huge tie-in. Just look at these epic battle sets. We have Jay in a funny suit, Zane's in a kinda funny suit, Kai looks like he has some story to it, and Cole's also looking like he's not really belonging in Ninjago. So putting all together, they look like they have some story behind them. They feel so random, and that leads me to believe that the 10th anniversary special will answer these questions, or at least some legacy shorts should answer those questions. I do believe at this point it's far from obvious that we are getting some extra content related to the 10th anniversary that should come out before season 14, and these epic battle sets just prove that all the more. Like I said before, these figures in the epic battle sets are kind of screaming to tell a story, and if they don't have a story behind them, and if we don't end up getting legacy shorts or a 10th anniversary special to answer these questions, then these figures are simply just odd because they don't come out of any context of previous Ninjago episodes, so it doesn't make sense if they don't have a episode context. Now, if the series of legacy shorts or the 10th anniversary did end up existing, how would it be? Would the bad guys or the ghost or the skeleton really be there? Or would it just be the ninja in funny suits fighting present day villains? I think it could go either way. Maybe the bad guys are just fillers because they're legacy and they kind of have to have a second figure, so they kind of just put them in there, but the good guy figures in these epic battle sets actually have some story. It could go that way, or there could be a huge legacy special or a reimagining of older seasons while Jay, Zane, Cole, Kai, and even Nia and Lloyd are fighting the bad guys in some funny suits. Who knows, the next level of this would be counting in the legacy sets and actually putting them in the story as well. So that would mean the legacy shorts would have the ninja turning gold. Maybe that's in a dream, maybe that's in another situation, but they would turn gold anyways, and the X1 Ninja Charger would be there because that is a 2021 set, and all the 2021 sets would be there, and all of them would kind of go together in some type of mashed up crazy story. It's very hard to see how the 10th anniversary sets are going to work, mainly because these sets were done in a way that nobody thought was possible. We never knew that they were going to make golden figures until the leak said so. So LEGO's playing their best cards for the 10th anniversary, and that basically means that it's going to be harder for us to actually predict what's going to happen. They'll come up with something so crazy and so awesome that it's impossible for any of us to even imagine it right now. In the end, comment down below if you think the 2021 $10 epic battle sets will ever be explained, or if they're always going to have no context. Thank you for watching this 2021 Thoughts video, and as usual, I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye!